and it took a long time. I studied this for years, I'm not even lying, because I've been brought up in a family that was super positive. My parents were always very, very positive. And they were always instilling that in my brother and I. So when I got to a certain age and I read a couple books, I saw that movie and read the book The Secret. You guys hear about that?
Yeah.
And I'll talk about that in a bit because it's an all right book, but there's some beefs that I have with it. And I'm definitely not shitting on Rhonda Byrne. She's done great things for people through that book. But that book, and when I saw the movie, it kind of made me think about my life. So I definitely owe credit to that, because it was such a big thing, right? Mm-hmm. Red Bull. And so I started deducing my life, and I came up with these 9 steps. And like I said, it took me a few years, because I wanted to get it right. If I'm going to talk to people, I won't bullshit you guys, and I won't do that. Another thing is, I'm going to be me. You're going to hear me dropping F-bombs and all that. I'm not going to do it to be like Andrew Dice Clay or anything, but, you know, I'm just here being myself. And I'll be straight up honest with you guys the whole time. Throughout my life, has it been a joyride? No. And you're going to hear stories, and they're all my stories, which I think is going to ring true with you guys the most. It'll hit home the most with you guys, right? Stories that I've gone through. Tons of failures, okay? Tons of successes, okay? But there's a little bit of everything, because that's what we all go through. I think that all makes sense if I present it that way. So that's what this is going to be about, these 9 steps, which I'll go through, okay? How I like to run these seminars is I like to speak. It's my show, guys. And then at the end, we can do a Q&A. Okay, I'll answer a few questions. I am on a time limit for how long I can hold the room. After that, video testimonials. If you guys, I don't care if it's one person or 15 or 20, I'll say it, or wherever I can go to do. Bo would love that too, because Bo's trying to get those videos for that testimonials. We'll do that as well. And at the very, very end, I want a huge group photo, which I always do. Seminars. How are we going to do this? I don't know. But at a timer on my camera here and everything. But we'll figure that out. So that's going to be the layout of the seminar. Okay? And with that, I'm going to get started. So, like I said, I was brought up in a very positive family. And throughout my life, I had that instilled with me. It's just naturally in my character, right? And like I said at the start, I've always wanted to be kind to people. I've always wanted to help others. There's a story that my mom told me, and this was actually recently, too. And she said, "You were always kind since you were a little kid. You know what you could do?" She said, "You would have your birthday party. I would open all my gifts, okay? And then I'd go to all my friends at the birthday party and ask them what to wear. Hook up everyone with toys, alright? And as soon as I saw that everyone was happy, I could grab whatever was left and go find the corner." And it's just like, okay, everyone's cool. And that's it. And so I've always had this, you know, wanting to help people. And that's where it's got me to this stage, right? This is something that I've guessed that I've always wanted to do, even though I didn't know. So, getting into these 9 steps, before I do that, there's one thing that I'd really like to talk about that really puts things into perspective, especially for me, and some people don't like hearing this, some do. It's called taking 100% responsibility for your life. And what I mean by that are the decisions that you make, okay, create the life around you. And where I am right now are through the decisions I made in my life. I made some bad decisions, and it's taken me down some nasty roads. But if you can take 100% responsibility for your actions, you'll be able to apply these 9 steps without a problem. And here's what I mean. I'm going to give you a couple stories. One's kind of funny, and the other one plainly sucks. Okay? As 9 years old, and my cousin Chris. Chris is awesome. This guy is like my big brother. He's not my cousin. That's how close we are. We set up this jump in my backyard, and I swear to God, like, the jump was like this. I'm a 9-year-old kid, right? So Chris is, and he's like 3 years older than me. He's just gaining all the speed, flies off the jump, and I'm just like, holy shit, I'm not doing that. And then, of course, what's the dude, Ryan? Come on. You got to do the jump. And I'm like, dude, no, I'm not going to do it. He's like, come on, egg me on. So finally, I'm next thing you know, I'm on my bike. Right? You got to go fast or else you won't get up the ramp and you'll fall down and just hit it, right? So as I'm doing this, you know how that moment when you're like falling down or something, it's like 2 years, just like, that's me approaching this bike ramp going, you idiot, right? And I'm like, oh no, just do it, dude, hit it. I bail, blood everywhere,
gravel on my face,
knees straight. Chris is laughing at me, you know, but just bail. Okay, the point that I want to make, what do you think the first thing I said to my mom when she came on and said, what happened?
I'm okay.
No.
Yeah.
It was Chris's fault. I pointed the finger at him right away. Right? It wasn't his fault. I'm the fucking idiot who got on the bike and went off the ramp, and that was my choice. And so I made that decision. There are some things in our life which we can't control, which I understand. But for the decisions that we make when your job, the majority of things that you do in your life are based off decisions that you make. And they're always going to bring you to where you are now. There's one story in particular, and it's a Devin Townsend Project story. I made sure there's lots of Devin Townsend Project stories. It's interesting. There's one story that really puts this into perspective. And I already knew about 100% responsibility that was happening. So, there's the Transcendence album that came out. A lot of you guys probably don't know that we wrote that record late in 2014. The majority of the record was written. And we were getting ready to go in the studio. 6 weeks before we were going to record that record, Devin pulls the plug on. And he goes, here's C2. Not one record, two records. 6 weeks before, completely new music. And if you guys know C2, right?
Yeah.
Especially Dark Matters. Yeah, it's not like fucking Sky Blue where you're doing No, it's like Ziltoid and taking a shit on everything. So I had to learn all that stuff. Like, and there was more than 24 songs, because there's B-side stuff and all that. So I had to learn upwards 30 songs in 6 weeks. We spent 6 months basically learning Transcendence and perfecting it. And here's Devin. Crazy. Yeah. To learn all the shit. Guess who has to track first?
Yeah.
Every time it's drunk. So 6 weeks to learn this. And the thing is, I'm always a sucker for a good challenge, right? Okay. I had no choice. It's my job at this point. I went into the rehearsal space for 8 hours a day, basically 6 days a week. After 4 weeks, I walk out of the rehearsal space with a massive headache and a ringing in my ears, which, you know, I've had several times throughout my life. That is just brutal, right? The next day, it's still there, it's like whatever. The next day, it's still there. A week goes by, it's still there. Now I'm getting a little concerned. Go to audiologist, they check my hearing, they're like, your hearing's actually pretty good. Considering you're a drummer, you haven't lost a lot of hearing. To this very day, it's ringing like a bastard right now. I have tinnitus and it sucks. Mm. You know, it's like when I talk about it, I hear it even more. Mm. When I go to bed at night and it's quiet outside or anything like that, this is all I hear. Left ear, and it's brutal. After 4 weeks of doing that, and then after realizing that I got it, you know what my first reaction was? I'm gonna fucking kill that guy. I'm gonna
see him, he's going to go, hey, Ryan. I was so pissed off. But before it even got to that, thank God it didn't get to that, I knew better. Because you know what? It was my choice to go into that rehearsal space for 8 hours a day, 6 days a week to do that. And there's nothing wrong with that. But here's the thing. When you play music for a really long time, especially drums with these things called cymbals all around you, I know, as you guys see, I'm only playing one or two of them. I have, like, every cymbal around my head, basically. And your ears simply fatigue. If you do not take breaks, your ears will fatigue, and that's when you start turning things up. I was protecting my ears. I had in-ear monitors and everything, and it was fine. But instead of taking a break, 15 minutes, that's all you need to do for ears to recover. Would hit hard, you know, and then I walked out with that, and all I did was deduce everything. I just went back to it, and I went, okay, what decision did I make that really brought this on? And it was my decision. It was my decision to go in there and practice 8 hours a day, not take breaks. It was my decision to keep on doing it, and that's something that I need, which sucks. And I have this for the rest of my life, unless they come over here. This is what I'm going to be dealing with the rest of my life. That's why when you guys see me playing with the cans over top of my inner monitors, it's to block out even more sound. You know, and I've been messing with these new in-ears where it actually blocks out almost as much as the combo. And I've been messing around with it in rehearsals because I don't dig the Princess Leia look, you know. we'll see what happens at this point with doing it tomorrow, but at the same time, it's like the last thing I want to do is make this worse. Anyways, 100% responsibility. When it comes to decision-making, when it comes to your life, we only live one life, guys. You're going to make mistakes. There's nothing wrong with mistakes, and I'll talk about that later, okay? But you need, at the same time, to take something what I call calculated risks. Every successful person is taking risks to get really. And an example of that for me is I had a job that paid me 80 grand a year. Devin Townsend Band was defunct, and we're jamming with Devin and stuff. He's working on DTP material. And I had this nice, cushy job. I was vacationing 4 times a year, never mind once. And Devin came up to me and was like, I want you to be the drummer for DTP. He says, you're my first choice. Let's do this. I'm going to go big going. It's going to be a full-time job. I'm going to require all of your time and blah, blah, blah. So at this choice of leaving 80 grand a year and making literally a quarter of that bank for that, and I'm not lying. To this day, it's like the money's all right. I definitely make more than that now, but not much. Okay? And that's cool. I'll get into that stuff again. That was my calculated risk, though. It's like, okay, if I go to do this, I am going to make money. I can teach on the side to make more money to supply the income and do this. But the most important thing is I'm doing it well. And that's what this seminar is all about. 9 sets of purpose. You know what? It's purpose. We all need purpose in life. And I truly believe in one thing that I always talk about. It's love what you do. That was my chance, and it's paid off massively. Right? It's been awesome. That's what I mean by calculated risk. If DTP didn't pan out or whatever, I had lots I could fall back on. I could become a full-time teacher and actually make more money with DTP. Not lying, I'm making money teaching. But it didn't matter. So I was doing this for my happiness, which is the most important thing. It's not about money. It's about happiness and loving what you do. That's a calculated. If it was like going for a band, like, oh, we're going to get a record deal, and blah, 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 and blah, blah, and then you throw it all away and then it does shit, that's dumb. The Tonight Story, that was dumb. Okay, what I did was just not smart. So, taking 100% responsibility for your life, being very careful of your decisions, and not even careful, being mindful. You know, because risks are good things to take if you really want to step it up against something.
but you got to be 100% responsible of your actions in order to do these next steps. And I know that for a fact because that's how I live my life, and it's turned out pretty good. So with the 9 steps, I'm going to go over them. If you guys have pen and paper, that's cool. Write it down. I encourage it. I know iPhone. I have an iPhone that has notes. Take all that stuff down, all you want. The only thing that I ask is just because I don't want this getting around me because I'm doing this for free and stuff, is to like video this whole thing and put it online, because then it ruins it for all the other people that I'm trying to do this for. If it gets online, then it's